Okay, good evening everybody. Much awaited announcement from the Mantri ji has come, which basically means there is no change actually. I don't know why he had to stop the whole thing yesterday, remove the notification, remove the information brochure and all that. Virtually he's repeated whatever was given in the notification yesterday. The same thing is continuing, except that there is a minor change in the dates, that is all. Except for that change, everything remains the same. So what was the announcement that was made yesterday? Let me just summarize that for you. First thing is that starting this year, there will be 4 attempts for JEE Main, and the first attempt will be in February, second attempt will be in March, third attempt will be in April, fourth attempt will be in May. And the best score will be taken for consideration for ranking purpose. You can take all 4. You can take 1, you can take 2, depending upon your choice. The choice has been given to you so that if the board exam dates clash with the JEE Main's date, you can choose a convenient date so that it doesn't clash with your board exams. So that is point number 1. Point number 2 is the pattern. Pattern, as I said, as was given in the notification yesterday and covered in our video, the pattern remains the same. Section A, that is the multiple choice, single answer right, 20 questions in each subject, maths, physics and chemistry will remain. Then there will be 10 questions in the numeric ability type, out of which you'll have to answer 5. The choice has been given to accommodate changes in syllabi from board to board, because each board has given different reduction in the syllabus for the plus 2 boards. So based on that, student can answer 5 out of the 10. Then the other one is in terms of the number of attempts, which I've already told you, the best of the 4 will be taken. And with regard to date, the date is that 23rd instead of 22nd. Yesterday it was said 22nd. Now he stated that it is 23rd to 26th. So basically there is absolutely no change since what we have stated yesterday. So we can, whatever we said yesterday in the video holds for today also. Let us wait for the notification. I think the notification should be put up immediately. We'll have to just check up. Maybe the notification will be put up today itself. Let's see, and the registration will start. Because if it is 23rd, then the registration should start immediately, because they'll have to give you a 1 month window for the registration. So before I sign off, one thing that we need to keep in mind is that you need to keep every document ready. Like I mentioned yesterday, you need to get your category certificate also ready. So category certificate, which is your SC, ST, OBC, or EWS, or PWD, any of these certificates, they have to be ready, because he's asking you to upload that. You have to keep in mind. Then there were a lot of questions yesterday as to what are the implications of these 4 attempts and all that? Should candidates take all the 4 attempts, etc., etc.? We'll do a separate video for that. But one thing is that life is going to get a little more complicated, because what is going to happen is, just imagine that the number of 100 percentilers will increase, because say there are 8 slots for each month. So we are talking about a minimum of 3,200 percentilers. It will be much more than that, because in every slot there will be more than 1% getting the highest mark. So minimum 3,200 percentilers we are talking about. It will be more. So till last year, the 99 percentile used to end at say around 11,000 rank or so. This time, 99 percentile will go up to, I don't know, 20,000, 21,000, 22,000, whatever. So there'll be a lot of contention for each percentile, and therefore there will be tiebreaker. So because the tiebreaker is there, your tiebreaker, you know the rules, they're going to look at your maths percentile, then you're going to look at your physics percentile, your chemistry percentile, and then they'll be looking at your age. So whoever is senior will have an advantage. So your maths percentile is going to be very, very important. So there is a question here about JEE Advanced. There is a lot of time for JEE Advanced. Don't worry about it. So JEE Advanced will happen after the fourth attempt of JEE Main, that too 45 days after the fourth attempt. So we are actually talking about end of June or early July, and I think early July is a likely time for JEE Advanced. Is there any change in exam pattern? Somebody is asking. There is a change with respect to 2021. There is no change since what has been announced yesterday. The same thing that you'll be given 90 questions, you got to answer 75 questions, and 20 questions, multiple choice, single answer right in each subject, maths, physics, and chemistry, plus 4 and minus 1, plus 4 for correct answer, minus 1 for wrong answer, and numeric ability type, you will be given 10, you got to answer 5 of them. There's a choice in numerical ability, and a marking scheme is plus 4 and no negative marks for wrong answers. So that is about the pattern. So in a nutshell, there is absolutely no change since what has been announced yesterday. It's just that perhaps the education minister wanted to make these announcements himself, and therefore the 13 languages in which the main paper will be presented this year still stays. So he wanted to perhaps be the first person to go live and announce that for the sake of the students, he is making these 4 slots for the convenience of the students. Also that to take care of the syllabus reduction, they have introduced choice for the first time. Also that it is going to be in 13 languages, that is English plus 12 regional languages. So he wanted to emphasize that a lot of these things are being done for the sake of the students, and he didn't want the opportunity to talk to the students directly and perhaps also claim credit for some of these things. I think the entire drama that we saw yesterday, that the notification was put up on the NTA website, the notification was removed at 7 o'clock just to allow the education minister to go live and make the announcements today. Anyway, he's got his satisfaction. Good for everybody. So whatever direction that we gave yesterday still holds. It means that, as I mentioned yesterday, that the JEE Main announcement will kickstart the academic activities in throughout the country. There is no time to be lost for the student. The student has to seriously start preparing for, or what I'm saying is revision, because I'm sure you've done a lot of preparation by this time. You need to start revising. Your revision schedule should be there. So no more excuses for any kind of procrastination. The date has come. The ball is in your court. The onus has now shifted to the student. There are some students who are giving excuse that it was online classes only. Please remember that everybody from Kota to Kanyakumari is in the same boat. Everybody is going through the same online classes. So we are talking about competitive situation here. We are talking about relative performance. We are talking about percentiles. So how you score relative to the others matters. So everybody is in the same boat. So therefore, so do not come up with these kind of excuses that we had online classes, syllabus was not covered properly, etc., etc. So leave these excuses behind and start concentrating. And as the minister has pointed out, you've got 4 chances. So you can take some of these chances as trial runs and do well in one exam or the other. So advantage to the student, make full use of the advantage and see how well you can do. Okay, there is one question about BITSAT. There's a lot of time for BITSAT. BITSAT normally will be around the same time as JEE Advanced. So we expect BITSAT most probably in June or July, early July. So there is still time for JEE Advanced. So don't bother about it. Okay. Which month is best for writing JEE Main exam? That's a $1 million question. I would suggest that if it doesn't clash with your board exam, make as many attempts as possible. You're not going to lose anything. After all, you just have to dedicate one day. We do not know how many students will take the exam on each of these days. What will be the competition? What will be the nature of the paper? We can't hazard a guess at this stage. Be open to writing the exam as many times as possible. Okay, so just do that, because each of them will be like a trial run. So do not get fixated about, you know, writing the exam on this particular day, this particular month only. Don't do that. Go ahead and write the exam. Only if it clashes with your board exam, then you should perhaps, you know, miss that opportunity. So just go ahead and apply. And anyway, you got to apply only for the February edition right now. What happens is after the February results come, you will be given a couple of days to apply for the March slot. So you will have time after the February results come out. Similarly, after the March results come out, you will have time to apply for April. And after the April results come out, you will have a couple of days to apply for the May slot. So there's a lot of flexibility built in. All right. Harsha Kiran, how to be consistent in studying? Harsha Kiran, you got to motivate yourself. All right. So now the big announcement has come. So far, perhaps mentally you would have thought that if not today, I will start tomorrow, etc., etc. Perhaps that impetus was not there. Now with the big announcement, you cannot postpone it any further. All right. So we know exactly when the dates are going to be. 23rd February. So therefore, work backwards. See how many days are available. Just see how much of effort that you can put in to complete the syllabus. Plan accordingly and see that every day you follow the plan. So miracles don't happen. This is hard work. It has to happen on a daily basis. It's not that, you know, on one particular day you will do some miracle will happen and you will become a superman and complete the entire syllabus. It's not going to happen. It is a hard grind one day after another. But you need to have a plan. Take 23rd, work backwards, see what you're going to do week by week and motivate yourself and take the mock test, take the grand test and prepare yourself for the exam. And anyway, we will do a separate video for that. Okay. So yes, Vishnu Priya, you have to answer 75 questions from 90 questions. That is right. All right. So on that note, we will stop the video here. We will come back with the analysis with regard to what you should be doing with regard to JEE Main, with the new pattern, what is the best strategy and all that. We will come back later. Okay. So the notification, I think, will be put up as soon as possible. And you'll be given a 1 month window. But of course, you're not going to wait till the last day. You got to apply sometime as early as possible. All right. So with regard to college opening and all that, there is time. Let us wait for the government to announce. As soon as the government announces, the colleges will be open. Okay. So all the best for you. Your preparation should start immediately. No preparation in the sense revision has to start immediately and no time to waste any longer. On that note, let's stop this video here. We'll meet again to talk about the strategy that has to be applied with regard to the new pattern. Okay.